Hello and welcome. I'm Dwayne Lessner. I'm in technical marketing at Nutanix, and I want to highlight some of the work that we're doing around containers and our Prism UI. So we're inside of Prism. We have, you know, the standard Nutanix cluster. We have also the ability to manage and distribute, run, build, monitor containers as well. Interestingly enough too, these containers can be virtual machines, or they can be physical, or they can even be hosted in Amazon. This one down here is in Amazon, and the other four are virtual machines. So we already have those up and running, but if we wanted to, we could take our container golden image, create a new one. We'll we'll pick this guy. We will clone. See container demo web. We'll give it just one. We'll create two vCPUs is good. We'll just give it about four gigs of memory. We'll hit save. So that guy's going to be cloned up. Then what we're going to do, we're going to turn it on and register it with our container machines. Power it on. Give that a guy a moment to power on and grab a IP address. You can click on the VM as well to get stats of what's going on. You can launch the console. Also, we can take a look at some of the containers. We only have two containers. We have one running off an image from Docker Hub. We have one that was baked in that one of our engineers wrote. We can actually turn this guy on, hit start. They're really fast to get up and running. So here's a console, simple hello world. It's up and running. You can take a look at the performance. It'll take some time to load there, but that's really super fast. We'll go back into our VMs. We have an IP address here now, 10.20.136.204. This is actually using Nutanix Acropolis networking. Open vSwitch. There's actually VXLANs providing the DHCP services. We'll go register that with our containers. Hit OK. So we have that created. We have some containers running, one stopped. So let's go create a bunch of containers. There's lots of views as well. You can sort by, you can group, do the circle view, go by host name. You can group by host name. So let's create a bunch of containers. We'll use the Nginx Docker image. We'll create 50 of them. Give it 100. Compute one. Give it 100. Hit save. That's going to, not only is it going to create those containers on our virtual machines, it's also going to distribute the load to Amazon as well. So we'll let that build out here. It'll take a moment, but really, in the scheme of things, pretty quick. So here we go. There we go. It's already loaded across our hosts. Fairly well balanced as well. So let's, we can go into the grid view. We'll group by image. Let's turn these guys on. We can highlight them all. Start them up. at all 51. All right, so they're turned on. Now we can go and well, maybe so by host name, we'll go into the one that we just created. Go back to grid. Getting a listing of all of the different containers across our hosts. The container, you can see that it's running the Nginx web services, providing that web page. And you can also see that my Firefox browser just got to that web page. So that's what I wanted to show, just some of the microservices and management that Nutanix is looking to support. That's what I wanted to show today. Thanks for your time. I think this is a really awesome glimpse into what Nutanix has planned for the future. And thanks again. Bye now.